Good morning, children. Sairam. Children, in the previous video, we all have completed the last topic of the first chapter solution, that is Wendt-Hof factor. And in that, I have told you that the molar mass calculated on the basis of colligative properties does not give the accurate value if the solution is concentrated or if the solute undergoes association or dissociation in solution, or you can say if the solute is an electrolyte. Now, on the basis of that, we have solved some numericals also. Now, we will proceed with some more NCERT questions. I have also told you to download the PDF for the NCERT questions. Those questions are very important from the examination point of view, and they generally come in the board exam also. We'll be solving some of the questions today, and after that, from next time onwards, we'll be proceeding with the second chapter of your chemistry, that is electrochemistry. Now let us start with the numericals of your NCERT book, the first chapter. Now see, a question is being displayed on the screen. The question is, vapor pressure of pure liquids A and B are 450 and 700 mmHg at 350 Kelvin respectively. That means you have been given P0A and P0B. Now, you have to find out the composition of liquid mixture and the total pressure given to you, that is PS value is given to you, it is 600 mmHg. Also, you have to find out the composition of the liquid phase. Now, let us solve this numerical. Now, see, we know that the formula according to Rawls' law is PS is equals to PA plus PB. Now, PA can be extended as P0A zeta A. PA is the partial pressure of component A, which is equal to the vapor pressure of component A in the pure state into its mole fraction. That is P0A zeta A. Similarly, for PB, it will be equal to P0B zeta B. Now, we know that zeta A plus zeta B is equals to 1. That is the mole fraction of all the components is equal to 1. If it is a two component system, then it will be zeta A plus zeta B is equals to 1. And here I have written zeta B as 1 minus zeta A. Now, putting these values, we get P0, 600, the value of PS is 600, value of P0A, which is given in the question, is 450, and zeta B, we have, zeta A will be calculating, 700 is the value of P0B, the vapor pressure of component B in the pure state, minus 700 minus zeta A. Now, solving this for zeta A, we get the value of zeta A as 0.4. Now, putting the value of zeta A in the formula, zeta B is equals to 1 minus zeta A, we get the value of zeta B also. That means we have calculated the mole fraction of component A and the mole fraction of component B. Now, what else we have to calculate? We have to calculate the composition of the vapor phase. Now, see how we will be calculating the composition for the vapor phase. We know the formula PA is equals to P0A zeta A. Putting the values, we get the partial pressure of component A. Similarly, putting the values in this formula, we get the partial pressure of component B. Now, total pressure will be equal to 600, which is also given in the question. That means what we are solving is absolutely correct. Now, we have to calculate the mole fraction. YA I have written instead of XA. Why? Because I am calculating in vapor phase. will be equal to 180 divided by 600. 180 is the partial pressure of component A and 600 is the total pressure. Similarly, for component B, vapor phase composition, 420, which is actually the partial pressure of component B divided by 600, we get 0.7. So your first numerical is solved. In this, we have calculated the composition of the vapor phase. Now let us proceed to the second question. The second question, as you all can see on the screen, the vapor pressure of pure water at 298 Kelvin is 23.mmHg. That means P0A is given to you. And it has been told that 50 gram of urea is dissolved in 850 gram of water. That means WA and WB is also given to you. Calculate the vapor pressure of water for this solution and its relative lowering. Vapor pressure of water you have to calculate. That means PA you have to calculate. Now see, the solution is there on the screen. The first of all, we are solving for the number of moles of A and B. Number of moles, as you all know, is equal to given mass upon molar mass. Given mass for component B, that is your solute, that is urea, is 50. Molar mass of urea is 60. We get number of moles of B, number of moles of urea as 0.833. Now similarly, the number of moles of A, number of moles of water, is given mass of water upon molar mass of water. Given mass of water is 850 and molar mass of water is 18. Dividing the two, we get the number of moles of water. Now, mole fraction. The second step is to calculate the mole fraction. To calculate the mole fraction of B solute, we have the number of moles of B divided by number of moles of B plus A. So it comes out to be 0.0173. See, it is 0.0173. Now putting the values in the formula for relative lowering in vapor pressure, that is P0A minus PS upon P0A is equal to zeta B. Children, I call this as PS. PS means either the vapor pressure of solution, which is equal to, which is actually because of only component A, so can be written as PA also, because B is a non-volatile solute. Now putting the values, P0A is given to you. P0A is given to you, that is the vapor pressure of pure water, 23.3 divided by 23.3. PA we have to calculate and mole fraction of component B we are having. So it comes out to be, so it comes out to be 23.39. Now relative lowering also can be calculated. It is equals to the mole fraction of component B, that is 0.0173. So your second question is also done. Now we'll proceed with the third question. Now you all can see the third question is being displayed on the screen. Boiling point of water at 750 mmHg is 99.63 degree Celsius. That means the value of water is given to you. It is P0A. Water is mostly the solvent and it's pure water. Boiling point is given. T0B is given to you in degree Celsius. Now how much sugar is to be added to 500 gram of water such that it boils at 100 degree Celsius? That means you have to calculate how much sugar, that is WB, should be added to WA is 500 gram and such that it boils at 100 degree Celsius. That means the elevation in boiling point should take place, and previously water was boiling at 99.63, now it should boil at 100 degree Celsius. Now let us see how it can be solved. See, we know that delta TB, the elevation and boiling point, is equal to the boiling point of solution minus boiling point of pure solvent. Solution for the Now, the boiling point of solution is 100 degrees Celsius. It is told that whatever quantity is added, it should come out to be 100 degrees Celsius. And that of pure solvent A is 99.63. So, elevation and boiling point comes out to be 0.37. Now, putting the value of delta TB in the formula for calculation of molar mass of non-volatile solute that we have done earlier. Calculation of molar mass of non-volatile solute, MB, is equals to KB, that is molar boiling point elevation constant, into 1000 into WB, that is the given mass of solute, divided by WA, that is the given mass of solvent, into delta TB, that is elevation and boiling point. Now, putting the values of all the things, MB, we know, is the molar mass of sugar, that is 342 molar mass of sugar. KB is given to you in the question, that is 0.52. And generally you can remember also, for water the boiling point elevation constant is 0.52 and the depression freezing point depression constant is 1.86. yes, so 0.52 into 1000 into WB, this we have to calculate, divided by 500. The weight of water is given to you, that is 500, into 0.37, that is the elevation and boiling point that we have calculated is 0.37. So WB comes out to be 121.7. That means if we will add 121.7 gram of sugar to 500 ml of water, then the boiling point will increase by 0.37 degrees. I hope you all are understanding. Now, one more numerical we'll be solving. See the question. Read the question carefully. It is two elements. Two elements are there, A and B. They form compound which are having the molecular formula AB2 and AB4. Now, two elements are there. They are combining two molecules, AB2 and AB4. Now, it has been told that if compound AB2 is dissolved, 1 gram of AB2 is dissolved in 20 gram of benzene, the freezing point depression takes place by 2.3 Kelvin. Whereas if 1 gram of AB4 is dissolved in the same quantity of benzene, the lowering takes place by only 1.3 Kelvin. And the molar depression constant is given to you. It is 5.1 Kelvin kg per mole. Now you have to calculate the atomic masses of element A and element B. Now see, I have divided the page into two portions. One portion is for the first compound, that is AB2, and the next portion is for the second compound, that is AB4. Now we know the molecular formula, this formula for the molecular mass of non-volatile solute from the depression and freezing point. It is equal to MB is equals to KF, that is depression molar boiling freezing point depression constant, into WB. WB is the molar mass of non-volatile solute, in 2000 divided by WA into delta TF. Now putting the value, Kf is given to you in the question, that is 5.1. Wb is the given mass of solute. You all know 1 gram only is added, so it is 1 in 2000 divided by Wa. Weight of benzene, that is the solvent, is 20 grams. And depression in freezing point, that is taking, is 2.3. So molar mass of component B comes out to be, the molar mass of solute, that is Ab2, comes out to be 110.87. Now similarly, solving for Ab4, again putting the values in the same formula, Mb is equals to Kf, whose value is 5.1 in 2000 into the Wb, that is 1 gram again, and divided by weight of solvent, that is 20 grams of benzene, and the depression takes place by 1.3. Solving this, again we get 196.15. Now we have calculated the molar mass for Ab2 and Ab4. Now the next step is, we are considering the atomic mass of component in this capital A to be small a, and the atomic mass of B to be small b. Now we are calculating the molecular mass of Ab2. Ab2 will be equal to mass of A plus mass of B into 2, which is equal to, we have calculated in the previous step, that is 110.87. Similarly, for component B also, it is equal to 196.15. Now subtracting equation second from first, we get minus 2B is equals to minus 85.28. So B comes out to be 42.64. Now putting the value of B in first equation, we get the value of A also, that is 110.87 minus the value of B, that is 85.28. So A comes out to be 25.59. So these two which I have enclosed in boxes are the atomic masses of component A and component B. Now children, we have solved around many numericals for the chapter. Now your chapter first, that is solutions, is over, and we'll be proceeding with your next chapter, that is electrochemistry. Now children, one more chapter has been added in your syllabus according to the CBSE, that is solid state. Previously, the last year, this chapter was not there in the syllabus, but now this year it has been added, and it is you can say is chapter first. We'll proceed with the chapter first later on. Now we'll be proceeding with your third chapter, that is your electrochemistry. Chapter 1 now is solid state, chapter 2 is solution, and chapter 3 is electrochemistry. In the next video, we'll be proceeding with chapter 3, that is electrochemistry. Children, I request you all to kindly solve all the numericals of your chapter solutions in some rough notebook or the previous year notebook. Many pages are left in the previous year notebook. You can solve these questions there and do practice. Some important things of the chapter I can tell you, which generally comes in the board exam, the theoretical portion and the numerical portion. In theoretical portion, the thing which is generally asked in the exam is to state the Rawls law under both the condition, when both solute and solvent are volatile, when the solute is non-volatile, state Rawls law. This question comes. Similarly, the next question that generally comes is, what are ideal and non-ideal solution, with examples you have to learn. The third thing that generally comes in the exam is, what is meant by positive deviation from Rawls law or positive deviation from ideal behavior, along with the example you have to learn. And on the basis of the colligative property, generally the numericals only come. A 1 mark question can be asked to explain what is meant by Kf and Kb, that is the ebullioscopic constant and the cryoscopic constant. You have to state that what is meant by Kb and what is meant by KF. Similarly, the next thing that comes is on the basis of Wendhoff factor, the numericals. On the basis of colligative properties and Wendhoff factor, numericals only come. And on the basis of Henry's law also, numerical can also come, and theoretically also it can be asked, what is Henry's law? So how you have to prepare the chapter? From the beginning only, the first thing that you have to learn is what is Henry's law. Before that, you have to learn the examples of solution of solid in liquid, liquid in liquid, gas in liquid. These examples, the first thing. Second thing, Henry's law, applications of Henry's law. Third thing, Rawls' law under both the conditions. Fourth thing, ideal, non-ideal solution. Fifth thing, positive, negative deviation from ideal behavior. The sixth thing is colligative properties. Generally, the numericals are asked, or KB or KF are asked. And on the basis of Wendhoff factor also, numericals are asked. So children, I request you all to kindly practice all the questions of the NCERT. Generally, the questions come from NCERT only. Each and every line of the NCERT book is very important. The MCQ type question or the objective type questions are made from the NCERT book only. Do read the NCERT book. It is very, very important. And thank you, Sairam.